Okay, so you've purchased a new Trezor device. What do you do now to store your crypto offline on a hardware wallet using the Trezor 3? The first thing you do when you plug it in is it's going to tell you to go to the Trezor website and start there. Now, what I'd like to do to make sure I securely download the app only from the Trezor website is I'd like to go to Google, type in Trezor IO, and you should see the official website come up in the first result. So let's click on that. It's very important that you install the app from the official Trezor website and nowhere else. You'll see the secure shield in the top left, just to make sure. What you need to do, go to the app. You can then download the application to run your Trezor either on Windows or Mac or your mobile. I will just click download for desktop here. It will automatically know that I have a Windows PC and it will download the correct version. Okay, once that's downloaded, you need to install the software. It shouldn't take more than a couple of minutes. Okay, there it is. It's installed and we've opened it up. I personally choose not to allow anonymous data collection. Confirm. Okay, so now what does it tell you? You've connected a Trezor Safe 3. Okay, the first thing you need to do is just read these instructions here. If you have any concerns that your Trezor device is not authentic, then click on this button here. But if you've bought it from the official Trezor shop, as I recommend you do, and the hologram when you receive it is intact and does not say void, and the package has been untampered, you should be good to go. So let's go set up my Trezor. You've got the option of choosing, I've purchased a Bitcoin only wallet, but in a different tutorial, I'll show you how to install firmware that is universal. So it allows you to access other coins as well. In this occasion, I will choose to install this firmware and it should take a minute or two to install. And you'll see that on your Trezor device. Okay, that's done. The device will load and the continue button should appear. The next thing it'll do is check that it's a genuine product. So let's click start. On your device, you need to click the allow button to let it check that it's an authentic and genuine device. Done. Okay. So now you should do this quick tutorial so you know how to use your device. So let's click on the right cursor here. All right. Continue clicking right. It'll show you how to hold to confirm. It'll show you how to scroll and navigate. It'll also show you how to confirm holding both buttons at the same time. That's it. You can do it again or you can continue. And that's a quick how to use your device. Then you can click continue on the screen. Now this here is an important step. You can either create a brand new wallet, which will generate a brand new seed phrase. The seed phrase are the keys to your crypto, or you can recover a wallet if you've previously created a seed phrase and you want to restore that access to that account, you can recover. In this instance, we'll create a new wallet. I recommend going with, if you scroll down, going with the legacy backup types and going with the 24 word backup, as that will be the most secure. You just need to make sure that you do not store it electronically, don't take a photo of it, do not put it on your computer. You must store it offline on something that doesn't have any access to the internet, such as a piece of paper or any other fancy ideas you might have. So you can go to create wallet, then back on your Trezor, it'll ask you to agree to the terms and conditions and click on create wallet when you're ready. Okay, it has generated a seed phrase for you. What you should do now is back up that seed phrase. So continue to back up. You need to acknowledge these three things here, that your wallet backup lets you recover funds in case of loss or damage. Never take a picture or digital backup, and store your wallet backup securely and don't share it with anyone. Like I said, these 24 words are the keys to your crypto. The crypto is not stored on the Trezor, it's stored on the blockchain, and this is your key to access that. Back onto your device, it'll ask you to continue. And just a double confirmation that you will not put the backup anywhere digital. Okay. And then show words. Now here's where you'll write them down on a piece of paper and store that somewhere secure. You need to make sure that they're written down with the correct spelling and in the correct order, because spelling and the order of these words matter. If you get the order wrong, that is the equivalent of having a different set of keys and you cannot access your crypto. So spelling as well as the ordering must be 100% correct. Okay, let's go through these. Pledge, field, flash, grow, glue, symptom, century, catalog, deputy, salute, point, manual. That's the first 12. Keep going. Snap, crazy, this, absurd, birth, gasp, mother, ivory, nose, foot, find, and chalk. Now I'm going to prove that these are the keys to an account. I might leave a small sprinkle of crypto in there for the first person that gets to it. You can have it. Anybody that has access to these words that you generate will be able to access your crypto. So again, make sure that it's stored securely and make sure nobody else gets access to it. Separately, in a different tutorial, I'm going to cover passphrases. So now that we've done that, we've captured those 24 words. Let's hold down to continue, hold down to confirm. Now it's going to do a bit of a check, correct the word for each position, continue. What was the fifth word? It was glue, and I'll hold down both keys to select. So both at once. What was the 15th word? This. Third was find. Okay, success. You've finished verifying your wallet backup. Continue. Done. Continue. And now the wallet backup is complete. You have the seed phrase to your funds. I highly recommend now you continue to set a PIN. The PIN is only for access to your Trezor device, not to your crypto. This is just so anybody that tries to use this particular device in your hand can only be accessed by you. So let's set a PIN. Yes, turn on PIN protection. Yes. PIN can be between 4 and 50 digits. Continue. Now I'm just going to do 1, 2, 3, 4 for simplicity. Please don't do that yourself. And don't make it your birthday. Don't even think about that. That's too easy. One extra by mistake. You can also go back and delete. There you go. And when you're done, click enter. Now it's going to ask you to re-enter that. Done. So now you've got a PIN code protecting the access to your Trezor device. And now back on the screen, your PIN is set. Continue. Again, I've only installed the Bitcoin only firmware. So in my instance, I've only got Bitcoin to keep activated. So let's click on complete setup. And the setup is now complete. Let's go to the suite. You've got the option to display your balances when your device is not connected to the computer. If my PC is stolen, I prefer that nobody has access to see the funds unless they have this physical device. So I'm going to skip. And this is what the Trezor Suite dashboard looks like. Now we'll cover next steps in a couple of other tutorials, but basically, after this all loads, what you can do is make sure you can go to the Bitcoin wallet and you can choose to receive and you can show the full address. It'll ask you to confirm on your device that the address matches the one on screen. Click both buttons to confirm. And then you can copy this address and then send your Bitcoin or any other coin. Just make sure you use the right network from wherever it's currently stored to transfer it onto this brand new fresh account. Now, before you transfer all of your Bitcoin or other crypto onto your new accounts, I have a little way to make sure that you absolutely know how to access this account if everything was wiped. For example, your Trezor was lost. Your PC was stolen. How do you access it? You need to make sure you know how to get back in and access your funds. And so I recommend sending a small test batch first and then completely wiping your Trezor device and this software from the computer or wherever it is for you and learning how to recover your wallet. Okay, thanks for watching. Feel free to ask any questions that you have below and like and subscribe. See ya.